How are we doing today? Good. Well, we're excited to be back practicing again. Had a really good work all summer, good work in the off season. Continue to try to build on that during camp, but I don't care what you do in preparation. When you start practicing, it's just a little bit different. So today's an opportunity for every player to see where they are and what they have to do to get where they want to go. And I think the point that players have to understand is they have to invest in themselves. We're not really asking them to sacrifice anything, but if we're going to practice well and have guys sustain it and be able to sustain the entire practice, which means they can finish plays, finish practice, finish games, then they have to take care of themselves off the field, how they eat, how they hydrate, how they sleep, as well as be able to take advantage of taking care of themselves when they get on the field. And I think that's critical that especially new players at a lot of positions have the opportunity to get lots of reps. I think that's the key for their development, especially in fall camp, and how they're going to be able to contribute early on in the season. So really not much else to say about it at this point. After one practice, you can't really make a lot of evaluations about who did what. We'll watch the film later and kind of see where guys are and take them from wherever they are to wherever we need them to get and try to get them to commit to trying to get there. So.
Okay, we'll start with Michael here on the aisle.
Yeah, a lot was made about your comments yesterday about the 21 team being a rebuilding year. What is your response to that and how do you?
Well, I don't understand what's so hard to understand when the point being we were young. And we should have 9 starters back on offense and 9 starters back on defense. That's the point I was trying to make. 6 guys went out for the draft. So as we usually have to do, we have lots of rebuilding to do again this season. So that's the point that I was trying to make. So when you have a lot of young players playing, I don't think our standard is like everybody else's standard, but when you have a lot of young players playing, you're actually trying to rebuild. So those guys get the kind of experience you need so they can play at the level you need them to play at so you can play to the standard you want to play to.
Charlie? Do you just have an injury update on guys that may be out for camp and guys that were out in spring that may be where they are now?
I don't know who you're talking about specifically. I don't have an injury report in front of me.
In the spring, I think it was Darian and Ja'Cory were out and maybe any guys that might be out for camp.
Darian and Ja'Cory are back, so that's not an issue. Look, we're going to have guys that are able to practice and not able to practice on a daily basis, and we're not going to have an injury report every day about who practiced and who didn't practice. So those guys are practicing, though. If you ask me specific questions, I'll be glad to give you specific answers.
Chase up front.
What does it do?
Well, I think it's really good for the players. I think the comfort zone that they have, same play caller, same signal callers, same system, same presentation of that system. We don't change the system when we change coordinators, but the personality and how that gets presented sometimes is a little different. So I think there's a lot of sort of comfort level with players. I think our staff did a really good job. We had a couple new additions on both sides of the ball and special teams, but I think they did a really good job of quality control, what we need to do better, what we can do better, how we want to try to improve. So, you know, this first day, we just want to see where we're at and kind of go from there, but it's always good to have continuity in the staff.
What have you seen from the tight end group just in terms of what you were able to bring in and how confident are you in the depth you have after Cam Latu?
Well, Cam is going to be missed sometime in camp. I don't know exactly how long, which is an opportunity. I think we have a couple, 3 freshmen, young guys that have an opportunity to develop. So it'll give them a lot of reps and a lot of opportunity in camp. So that's a position that we definitely need to develop some depth at, and this will give us a good opportunity to do that.
Do you know what's wrong with Cam? Or
Yeah, I do.
You've talked a lot about the competition at cornerback. In terms of the mindset you've seen from those three, four guys as they head into that, where's that mindset at right now?
I don't know. Just like I don't really know what's wrong with Cam. I was at practice today, but I don't know what's wrong with him. So I don't really know what the mindset of the quarterbacks are either, you know, as if I wasn't at practice today. Look, the quarterbacks have worked really hard. Bryce has done a really, really good job from a leadership standpoint, as well as understanding the offense, a lot of confidence in what he's doing, making good decisions. I think he sets a really good example for the other guys. I think Jalen Milroe has had made a significant amount of progress. We still want to continue to work with him and develop. And Ty is a young player who's in the developmental stage, but we're pleased with the progress he's making. So I think everybody's got a really good attitude if you're asking about mindset, and I think everybody's really working hard to try to get where they'd like to be and where we would like for them to be.
What did you want to see change with the offensive line, whether it was schematic or just mentality-wise from last year, and how have you seen that implemented in the spring and up till now?
I don't think there's any question about the fact is we need to play better in the offensive line. I think we need to be more physical up front, first of all, and get movement on the run. Being more consistent, I think having more diversity in the running game would also help. And I think the additions that we've made in the offseason is going to be helpful to that. And I think overall, we just have to have a different mentality up front in terms of the intangibles that we play with, the toughness, the effort. You know, the offensive line is a place where that gets established on your team. And we need leadership. So that the players actually understand the standard that we need them to play to, and somebody is going to not accept the fact that guys aren't playing that way. So, but I like the players that we have. I like the attitude that they've sort of played with to this point. I like the coach that we have now and his energy and enthusiasm, the way he's teaching the players. I like the additions that we made in a running game to maybe add a little more consistency there, which is going to help play action passes and a lot of other advantage throws that we can make if we can run the ball effectively. So I think it's a very important part of what we need to improve on, but I'm kind of encouraged by it.
Hey, Coach. So talking about the mindset, I know that the hunger for this team after losing in the national championship has been on their mind this entire offseason. I want to know from your philosophy, you've been on both sides of that, when do you want players to turn and focus on the new season, or do you like that edge throughout the season to kind of have that in the back of their mind that they want to get back for that redemption?
Well, I'd like for players to have that kind of edge for who they want to be, how they want to play, to be the best players that they can be, regardless of what happened last year, whether they won and had success like we did the year before, whether we lost. And, you know, there's a little humiliation in terms of pride in performance and not being able to finish the way we'd like, losing a game in the fourth quarter. I think all those things are motivating factors for players. Now, you've heard me speak many, many times. People respond better when things don't go well. I like for players to respond well no matter how things go. When they go well, they're kind of relentless in continuing to try to improve, not be satisfied, not be complacent. I think it's human nature sometimes to feel that way, but that's not something you can do if you really want to be successful and play at a high level on a consistent basis, because hopefully we're going to be able to have success and players are going to have to be able to deal with that success, and they're going to have to accept the challenge that we're going to play against a lot of good competition and everybody's going to try to give their best game when they play against us. So regardless of whether we're winning or losing, I want everybody to want to play to a standard. Although I do acknowledge the fact that, you know, when you lose, when bad things happen, from a human nature standpoint, people seem to respond a little bit better. Is that what we want? No, but I think that's probably something that is pretty normal for most of us human beings.
All right, Coach, thanks for your time.
All right, thank you. Appreciate you.